Hi. One of the major mistakes that entrepreneurs do at the beginning of their entrepreneurial adventure is not spending enough money in the appropriate places. I have heard so many stories from entrepreneurs who regret, deeply regret, that in the first few years they sort of wanted to save money. Now I understand that because when you're starting, money is exceptionally precious. Now, when you're already cruising, there's money coming in from revenues, that's fine. You're feeding yourself. But still, money is valuable. But when you're starting a company or an organization, you need money. And that money is either your money or borrowed money or investors' money. And there's so much risk and there's so many things to spend money upon, you know, when you're starting. So some people, you know, take sort of the shortcut of trying to sort of do everything at home, or many things at home, or by themselves, so that they can save money. And experience shows that this might not be the best option, because first you need to free yourself from the small things so that you could do the big things, because the organization now at its startup phase needs all your attention. So you're needed for the big things. Don't waste your time doing things that other people can do. Second, if you do things that you're not an expert with, you know, then that the result will be compromised. And in the end, who's going to pay the price? Whatever you're starting, the startup itself, the organization. So why put yourself in that situation? Spend some money, it's okay. But give the task to the expert. If you need legal advice, instead of you going through the contract and missing maybe some important points, hire a legal person. You don't have to hire him or her or the organization on permanent basis. You can hire it on freelance basis. And now we're so fortunate that so many of these services are done online. And there are organizations where, you know, it's a hub for these people, for these, you know, specialties, where you post a sort of a need for a service, and then people bid. And then you choose whoever has, you know, offers the best option in terms of quality and price. You too choose that one, and then they do the job. And all of that is done in online. So there's so many facilities now for freelance. So use this to get experts do the job that you want. You see what I'm saying? Same thing, let's say, for, you know, managing your social media, for your digital media strategy, for whatever it is, some HR services. You reserve your energy to handle the big issues, to solve the problems that require your decision, because only you can make those decisions. You're the center of the whole process now as it begins. You see what I'm saying? So don't, you know, tie yourself up with small things. And don't compromise by, you know, on quality, by you doing things that are not even your line of specialty. You'll end up paying far more as a consequence of this in the future. Don't do that. If it's going to cost you a little more money, it's okay. Think of it as an investment in the healthiness, the immunity, and the energy, and the well-being of the organization you're going to, or you are building now. So invest money where money is due. Don't have shortcuts. Be generous, especially at the, you know, early stages, you know, when you're laying the foundation. It's like when you want to build a tower and you're being sort of, you're saving money and being cheap on the foundations. Can you imagine the impact of that? So the more you lay stronger foundations through getting experts and specialists to do these key jobs, the better is for your organization, and the more you can secure peace of mind in the future, and as well as, you know, higher chances of survival and success.